Мы поговорим о первичной профилактике рака шейки матки путем вакцинирования против ВПЧ-инфекции. И здесь, значит, частота заболеваемости раком шейки матки в Российской Федерации составляет 15-13 тысяч населения. Смертность составляет 6,1 на 100 тысяч населения. И по числу заболеваемости рак шейки матки находится на четвертом месте. И по смертности приблизительно 4-5 место также. Здесь приблизительно здесь некоторые цифры по странам, выбранным в совершенно случайном порядке, касательно количества заболеваемости и количества смертности. Вирус папилломы человека является причиной возникновения рака шейки матки, доказанным работами профессора Цухаузена, которые были сделаны еще в 70-х годах, за которые получил Нобелевскую премию в 98 году. В настоящее время описано более 205 типов ВПЧ. Рабочая группа Майера в 1995 году включила ВПЧ в список факторов карциногенеза для людей и в 2009 году определилась со списком онкогенных типов. В общей сложности включено 13 ВПЧ-типов, считается как онкогенные. Это 16, 18, 31, 33, 35, 9, 45, 51, 2, 6, 8, 9, которые являются точно доказаны карциногенными, и 68, который, скорее всего, является карциногенным. Как развивается рак шейки матки? Вирус папилломы инфицирует нормальную шейки матки, и у большинства женщин, практически 95%, вирус папилломы шейки матки самостоятельно исчезает через какое-то время. Считается, что приблизительно 80% самоизлечивается в течение первого года и 95% в течение трех лет. Значит, но у оставшегося 5% это ВПЧ-инфицированная шейка матки может инфицирование вирусом ВПЧ шейки матки может приводить к дальнейшей прогрессии, также как и обратной регрессии, да, формироваться при раковые заболевания и в самом худшем варианте возникать рак. Соответственно, когда мы говорим о возможности первичной или вторичной профилактики рака, мы можем говорить о вакцинации, направленной на нормальную шейки матки до того, как она была инфицирована вирусом ВПЧ, и вторичный – это скрининг, который направлен на, собственно говоря, выявление предраковых поражений шейки матки. Во времени заболевания рак шейки матки растянутая, как я уже говорил, достаточно долго, до 15 лет, с пиком на инфицирование ВПЧ, приходящееся на 25 лет, с пиком предраковых заболеваний на где-то возраст 30 лет, в среднем, это все очень в среднем, и ростом раковых заболеваний 35. И первичная профилактика направлена на устранение фактора, который приводит к возникновению заболевания. Значит, важный момент. Рекомендации ВОЗ на сегодняшний момент касательно первичной профилактики – это ВПЧ, вакцинация девочек в возрасте 9-13 лет. Общая рекомендация. Значит, специально хочу сказать, что касательно какие…
What dosages? How many dosages? I will talk more about that. In general, we've been working actively on developing a more or less acceptable approach towards vaccination with the lowest number of dosages. Today, we have approved three vaccines. One of them is bivalent one against papilloma virus, a 16th, 17th type, and the other one is quadrivalent, 16, 17 non-oncological types, and 6 and 11 non-oncological types, and it was recommended in 2015 to 2000, beginning from 2017. This is the only vaccine that is to be prescribed in the United States of America. And it's a nine-valent vaccine. We have to understand that when we vaccinate, we don't infect a woman with that virus. We just chase a vaccine with virus-containing units. This vaccine is safe, there's a big number of quite number of reports or messages from different countries. There have been messages from India, Japan, France, Kazakhstan regarding that they've prescription and some other countries regarding that the prescription of this vaccine can cause side effects. But the general consensus of all the agents involved in assessing the efficiency of this vaccine is that it's more efficient than any the other vaccines that have been prescribed to patients. The life cycle of the papillomavirus and the cervix. It begins at the moment when the virus penetrates the basal layer, and over time, this basal layer infected leads to a virus replication in a certain number of women in their cells, and all this over time, it happens over time in the cases of this virus. And this vaccine is aimed at this process to be prevented, so for an organism to develop a reaction to a virus infection, resistivity to virus infection. And I want here to say that in 2009, they started first programs of population vaccination among women in Australia, because Australia is most advanced country in terms of from the vaccination. And it's not surprising that we have some data that speak about the efficiency of quadrivalent against and 2 and 3. It's not all women. Initially, vaccination began from 3 dosages, but it's clear that not all women were able to get that kind of dosage. Someone would forget about that, someone would be missed, and there's big amount of information regarding efficiency of vaccination with different dosages. And in assessing the efficiency of vaccination with quadrivalent vaccine, it's clear that we assess, what do we assess? So we assess the premalignant lesion status, the plasia, hypochondrial and non-plasia, and inscription of the full course leads to 98% positive results in 97% C3, and prescription of in a situation when women get one dose efficiency, but 66% for CN3, and efficiency of bivalent vaccine has been assessed regarding SN1 and SN3. They have shown some kind of different figures, but the trend was similar. That the prescription of a fuller, a more complete, bigger type of vaccine. Cycle of vaccine, 3 injections provides for the highest effect, and including they assessed also the reduction of cervical dysplasia within 5 years after vaccination is done, which provides for a sustainable effect. In India, they have run some interesting research among 17,000 women who, for different reasons, had received three dosages. Of vaccine, or 2 dosages on different days, a different type intervals, and 1 dosage, and they received the result that due to different reasons, they kind of left out of those research, and that they assessed the results of a 70-year-long span, and it turned out that they found out that in such conditions when we have to think about the price of this vaccine in principle.
Назначать и меньшее количество доз.
In principle, it's enough to reduce the number of doses, which would be not very effective. However, they enable achieving at least some efficiency, provided that there is no adequate funding. And if we're talking about 3 doses, 1 dose, 2 doses. Of course, the studies that I mentioned were published 2009, and there are even more now. And International Cancer Studies Association plays a lot of a great role in replacing the three dose with two dose pattern. If the vaccination in men has to be undertaken, there is a very elegant study that has been undertaken 2010-11, and men have been vaccinated in the age at the age younger than 21, and an estimate has been made as to whether the number of warts on the genitals in that population decreases, and it was found out that the prescription of that vaccine, administration of that vaccine, leads to reducing the occurrence in the heterosexual and does not lead to reducing in homosexual population. And there are additional studies, but the general trend is that vaccination, it is desirable, depending, of course, on the funding conditions and the existing healthcare system in place. If it doesn't enable the vaccination of the comprehensive vaccination of the population, it's another story. But if the program is not well organized and the vaccine, like in some regions, is purchased for money by the recipients, then the vaccination of men would be welcome, because it creates a kind of a flock immunity or a herd immunity, which helps preventing in the future the papillomavirus infection of course, the population. Of course, the 9-valent vaccine is the most common vaccine in the United States, and the American Cancer Society in its report has indicated that if we use quadrivalent or bivalent vaccine to treat type 17 or type 16, and thereby prevent about 24,000 cases of cancer in the US annually, then this can lead to introducing the vaccine can lead to prevention of another 3,800 cases. And what countries is it effective? Here you can see the prevalence of the cancer of cervix in by country, and here there is a map where national funding programs exist for vaccination against the papillomavirus, human papillomavirus. Here, a few programs have been introduced in Moscow. And as you can see here, the picture is quite contradictory to the one that I've shown on the previous slide. And in principle, the overall trend is that since 2006 through 2014, about 118 million women have been vaccinated, 62 million have been vaccinated at health centers or schools, 13 million got vaccination according to the additional vaccination program, and others received it through opportunistic vaccination. What are the difficulties of introducing vaccination against HPV? The population is not taken stock of in the framework of national immunization protocols. A number of countries are working at reducing the cost and trying to manufacture cheaper vaccine, like China and India are working at it. And if it's effective enough, then reducing the dosages and also creating a pool of countries, for example, Gavi project, which supports low-income countries to achieve better price from the manufacturer. For example, Gavi project led to having the price of vaccine for those countries going down to $4 per injection. And one of the other problems is a mechanism of vaccination, where that vaccination can take place and what conditions. And one of the important moment is the time interval. And if, for example, it was a big problem in Brazil when given a higher percentage of the receiving the first dose, then the administration of the second dose has dropped significantly because people were less motivated and there was no more good response to the campaign and also monitoring and quality assessment. What percentage of population, assessing what percentage of female and male population has received the vaccine, and also sensitivity, tolerance of the vaccine, and also taking stock of the specific types of papilloma virus for this or that region, as well as the frequency of occurrence. The pre-malignant lesions, and also taking stock of registering the side effects and other hazards, and also we should introduce it into our healthcare policies. Also take stock of the recommendations, register all the recommendations of the for the target populace, target population, target group, also selecting one age category. Two doses are still recommended at the interval of 6 to 12 months. There are different strategies to that effect, also different strategies as to how it can be indicated, depending on the country or at school or at the healthcare institutions or via some public campaigns or in combination. And it is important also that the vaccination of girls provides for a good, if we provide a good coverage of feminine population, it would be better than